Located on the outskirts of a Dutch city, lays this ancient pottery works. With its over 400-year-old history of making roof tiles, this place truly had a very special atmosphere. Join us on this adventure in this time capsule-like factory. We will start our exploration in this shed. In this shed, one of the last processes of the production of roof tiles were done. And this process was the cooling of the hot tiles. This process also explains the countless rows of wooden racks. The cool thing about this is that this kind of manufacturing completely disappeared in Holland. Except for this last desolate reminder. Nowadays, nature is slowly pouring into the ancient wooden structure. But okay, let's continue into the next part of this building. Around the corner, we came across pretty much the most important part. And these were, of course, the big old kilns. In these big kilns, clay tiles will be heated up to very high temperatures. After this, the clay became solid. Nowadays, this kiln has cooled down permanently. Behind this kiln, another one was located. It wasn't the same one though, as this one looked to be much older. You could notice this by the fact that this kiln was powered by wood, instead of natural gas, like the other one. And it was a nice layer of rust, covering the steel lids. It truly gave you an impression how the production must have looked like in the old days. But let's leave these kilns behind and head over further into this building. While doing this, let me explain what the story is of this old pottery works. And we have to travel back a really long time for this one, all the way back to 1675. This was the year when the first roof tile was manufactured on this site. This site was ideal due to the big quantities of clay in the nearby river. After the establishment of the plant, production went relatively smoothly and was always kept inside the family. In 1891 though, it was sold to a new owner, which renewed the whole factory with a brand new steam engine. A couple of decades later, it was yet again sold to a new family. This family had the luck of receiving money from the Marshall Plan. This money from the United States was invested into the last modernization. Even though it was modernized, the family wanted to keep the production as original as possible. Throughout the years, the lack of modernization was felt heavily. In the 60s, there were over 100 employees active in the factory. This number decreased to just 5 employees in the 70s. At this time, the wages were extremely low and the work conditions became barely bearable with the now ancient machines. At the end of the 80s, just one employee was active. Personally, I've no clue how just one employee managed to keep this whole factory running. In 2001, it was finally over. The over 300-year-old company had finally closed its doors. Okay, it's time to leave this part of the complex and enter into the next one.
Nee, we moeten hier de hoek om. Dat is vrij riskant met dat huis, maar dan kunnen we meteen, als het goed is, meteen links het gebouw in.
We had to be a bit careful though. Because the last owner is still living in the old director's villa. So swiftly we climbed over the old wasteland into the next building. Inside we were completely stunned. What we witnessed was a still completely intact production line. Even the old wheelbarrows were still against the wall, like they could be used anytime. And you had this beautiful sight of a big wheel. Even with the outdated looking design, this was in fact the most modern part, dating back to the 1940s. The function of this machine is pretty unknown to us, but I think it was for the molding of the roof tiles. But in general, it was just a completely stunning scenery. It's time to continue though, into yet another building. Making our way to that part though, we were distracted by probably one of my favorite corners in this old complex. And that was the old workshop. Which truly was something else. Filled with all kinds of historic machines, combined with these beautiful industrial windows, this room came straight of the Industrial Revolution. How long this scenery will exist isn't looking too good, looking at the already collapsing roof. But well, let's leave behind this stunning room and continue our exploration. In the next hall, we first came across an old yellow forklift truck. Behind these rubber dividers, a new production line began. And that was the pottery works, which was still completely stocked with all kinds of small clay pots. Next to this, the old kilns were also located, which were noticeably a lot more decayed. With this part done, we only had one last part to explore, and that was the old office block. In this part, decay was heavy, but vandalism had unfortunately also reached this part, so a lot of papers were scattered all over the room. With this, we will also conclude our exploration of this truly monumental pottery works. The future of this factory isn't looking too bright. This is due that all of the buildings are in a heavy state of decay, which makes restoration extremely expensive. But for now, this rare piece of industrial heritage will keep rotting away.